Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, y'all. Good morning, Cafecito.
Good morning.
I'm
just waking up.
Literally running out of bed right now.
Don't worry about the lines on my face either.
You see a big old Apple Watch across her cheek? Hey, too bad these hoodies will not be included in the Her Mystery boxes.
I know. These are too brand new, though. I'm thinking... I can't see you. Sorry, y'all, about my cup. Look at these new Cafecito Time hoodies. Yeah. I'm obsessed. Are we going to make them available to pre-order when? When this drops or already?
How about this? Let us know in the comments what you know if you want some of these or there's something you would like to see. However, I do want to make one change. Right here it says, with Chingo Bling and...
Mm-hmm.
Like, that should probably be blue, right? Because if we make them on these hoodies, it kind of like...
Oh, I kind of like it with the neon.
But can you read
it? Because it's subtle. Like, okay. Chingo Bling and Mighty Soul.
Oh, okay. See,
it? Yeah,
see Mighty Soul, she knows about fashion.
No,
stuff
I
like
think
that.
It's subtle. So it's like, this is what's really important are the host. With and are just like, you know.
Juan was telling me that for every cup of coffee... We're supposed to be drinking like a lot of water.
And I know. Though. Why do you think that's why I walk around with a cup of water and coffee all day long.
I be just drinking coffee like that's my water.
No.
Like, so he says like, yo, you get real dehydrated.
Exactly. That's why I walk around with a coffee cup and a water jug.
He said 8 cups of water for each cup of coffee.
Like well, I drink two of these, so I'm on my second one by the end. I mean, you fill it up for me sometimes. So I'll ask you like, hey, can you fill up another one? So I have two of these a day minimum.
And when she says it, sometimes I jump a little bit. And my tío, Hugo gets mad. Wait, you can't just jump because she gives you a command. They were laughing because
listen,
so you wait a second.
When you're getting up that fast to do something for your girl, that's because she's doing some other stuff.
Come
that's
on
right.
Now.
You know what
Come
I'm saying? I mean, I'm just saying.
It's a game,
ladies. It's real easy math. You do for him, and he will jump to do whatever it is.
That's why I jump real high.
You know what I'm saying? Just saying. The dishes.
I'll be like, how high?
You who is gonna be like, well, that's why they're always jumping for me, so I don't have to jump.
Yeah. Well, dude, I'm excited about seeing Theo Juve do his thing on stage, the antics. So these comedy clubs, they're gonna have to like, look, we're doing maybe we might do a beer chug contest. I don't know if he's gonna be handing out roses or taking shots with the. I don't know what Juve has up his sleeve. Crowd work.
It's gonna be something.
I mean,
I can't wait. It's gonna be fun.
He might need a clienta up on stage. He might call a clienta up to the stage.
Coming up to the stage. So are we gonna wear these hoodies every time we're on? I think we should.
You gonna make it like a uniform?
It's like my uniform. It's gonna be so much easier than trying to figure out what I'm gonna wear today. You need to have them in 3 colors. Like it needs to be right. It's my job. This is our job.
What else would other colors would it go well with? Like
I think black for sure.
Like super black, but like.
I don't know about gray.
Yeah, no.
I like black. Black and white. What would it
but,
be?
But like, you know what would be yellow? A dope yeah, black? Almost like the comfort colors black. Like, almost like worn, like vintage. Like, not just straight black.
Like mineral?
Not just a off-the-shelf gilding black.
Mm. Like a black, like a cup?
No, like a ashy black, like a gunmetal.
Oh, like a gunmetal. Yeah, that'd be kind of dope.
Like a little ashy black.
They sell those
kind of
sweaters though.
I mean,
yeah,
they're expensive.
They're
though.
More pricey,
like,
but
with like you know what I'm saying. Yeah. Just like a different.
Yeah.
Just so it's not such a like regular.
What about that darker brown one that I brought? Like that more of a remember? They're in my studio.
What are they like the hats he has? Like the dark brown hats?
No, it's like a darker. Like it's like not as dark as that brown, but.
Oh, let me chug my water. Hey, we didn't do the simultaneous.
We did. We said cheers. Happy New Year.
Oh, we did a cheers. Happy New Year. But, you know, inhale the good stuff.
Exhale the
BS.
Okay, so I've been just cleaning and cleaning.
And cleaning.
And cleaning.
And went to Costco and then came back, finished cleaning.
And cleaned. I just want everybody to know that.
Oh. My baby brought me some Costco socks. I'm happy.
Okay, you know I had
Next
never
thing you
been
know,
to
she
Costco.
She gonna bring me draws.
Listen, I had never been to Costco. I'd been to Sam's. but never to Costco. Actually, I think we attempted a Sam's membership at one time, and we never went. Like, I just didn't care for it. So I just assumed that Costco was equivalent to Sam's. So why am I going to go to, if I just don't need to go there? Yeah. My sister's like, you should really.
Well, I've been knowing, like, for big, like, the all your paper products and napkins
so,
and all that.
So why didn't you go?
I never really went or made the effort. No, yeah. I'm just saying, like, when it's time to re-up, it's, I'm not saying, oh, I knew before you. That's the not day, what I'm saying.
You know, the day before the apocalypse, we going.
Well, I mean, I had already bought toilet paper, and I had already bought paper towels in the bulk from HEB, but I didn't know I got a lot more at Costco for the same price, even though it's the same size, the same bulk amount. Does that make sense? Obviously, HEB is going to be more convenient, right?
Especially when you got little kids and they eat like specific basic things. Like, we want pizza for lunch. Okay.
And they got those big box pizzas.
Well, you can get your
box. Well, I bought a whole, I get right now, I buy one little pack that has two of them. Like, I just literally bought a 12 pack. So you're having to get.
And is it on that? Tostitos or?
No.
Man, I wish.
I buy them, you know, I got to buy them the better brand. I don't even know what brand it is. Some HEB brand.
Which one? Jordan, what is it? DiGiorno's?
I don't know. It's supposed to be better than the other ones.
We Costco now, baby.
Hey, but listen, and then they get the cauliflower one.
Oh, yeah, so they like the cauliflower
pizza. So I got to get that. They did have those at Costco, and I was going to do it, but I didn't remember if we had any in the freezer.
And she's like, because I was like, hold on now. Let me calculate Bidenomics.
Hey, are you single people that have Costco cards? That could be like
my sister. That's how I went. That could
be leverage. Just be like, hey, if you start dating me, you get a Costco membership. Hey, it's one of the perks.
Yeah.
Well, my sister was the one that told me. Profile.
No, her sister was tripping. Like, why are you getting? Oh man, it's a lot of stuff, and it's like
she's like, oh my god, that was a lot of money on groceries. Why are you getting so many yogurts? I'm like, okay, right now
you by yourself,
we get six, and we finish those in 3 days
because
we
got to share that.
I get one, you know,
we got four.
So now it's like
one, I get,
and now it's Monday and Tuesday, and by Wednesday we're done. So we're like, I guess there's no yogurt for dessert. Sorry.
Then you're in that pantry.
What can I get up in this pantry?
So in other words, she didn't really know how to do the calculate. Like, oh, literally, when it's just you, you can. I mean, you. She's like, whatever.
She was like, wow. She's like, I don't know that I want kids to have like a whole. And I said, yeah, I know. It's like a whole.
She got anxiety from like thinking about how like families.
Yeah, and it was funny because one thing that I want to do better this year is, I don't know if anyone's guilty of that. Who's watching?
I don't think there's any room for improvement.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying?
Look at him.
My tío Hugo over there, like.
Hey, so I'm gonna do better at keeping track.
Better keeping track of what?
Groceries, like grocery bills. Does that make sense? You see, how I'm able to keep such good track of how much we're gonna spend is because I don't go grocery shopping. I buy online, and so everything's being tallied up. So then it gives me the opportunity to see if I'm just buying crap or if I'm buying things that I really need it, right? Going to the grocery store, you start to see like, oh yeah, I forgot I hadn't bought almonds in a hot second. Let me buy some almonds as my snack. When you're walking around, you know? Luckily, they don't really have that whole as soon as you come in. It's like as soon as you come in, they're smart. Instead, they have electronics and clothes, and you're just like I spend a whole 20 minutes there before I was like, where are the groceries, Cynthia? I'm like, she's like, oh no, we got to start over here. I was like, oh my god. I was like, I was not ready for
this field trip.
Oh my gosh, I bought a jacket. I ain't even gonna lie, it's a nice little jacket. It is, right?
Yeah.
I bought a little jacket.
And curtains drip.
Man, I was like,
shout out to Her Apparel, though. Her Apparel, they got a mega sale at the Hive.
We're going to have a mega sale at the Hive, end of January. And then, on top of that, I'm doing a mystery box on herapparel.tx.com.
Mystery box.
So it'll be $100, $100 mystery box. I know you're thinking like, $100? I know, but it's so much in there. Like, I'm really needing to make a room for inventory. So like,
Earrings, shades,
bracelets, purses. It might have a dress in there. It might have a t-shirt. I mean, it's going to be really a variety of things.
It's more than the value, though. It's
worth way more than the value. I kind of did two. I thought it was $250, but really, to be honest with you, once I like added the other accessories that I thought, like, I'm just going to add these, ended up being a little bit more. So I'm kind of like not making my money all the way, but it's cool. I just didn't make room in my studio, so it's all right. I'm hooking up my peeps.
And my merch store been jumping. Thank you guys very much. Packages been going out.
Okay, so I like that you guys put up the Fedia team jackets that everybody was like, where can I get it? I like the idea of having a different style jacket for next year, so that every year it's a different jacket, you know?
Yeah.
I'm excited about the one for next year. Or this year, I'm sorry.
Saying next year.
My God, I
good
forget.
Good morning, Marisol.
Hello. That's why I got these lines on my face.
Yeah. Yeah, my baby's, it's probably all the asbestos she was breathing in from, from cleaning. She was going colchas out of the closet.
Okay.
Board games and
I thought we had taken out all our winter clothes.
No, there was still like another bag up there.
No, another three bags, my G.
It's like hoodies and, because think about it. You go to El Paso, you might buy your Chihuahua hoodie from the airport. Somebody give you another thing and, you know, you buy another sweater at the airport. Before you know it.
Okay, it's like I bought the jacket today. No need for that jacket. Just saying. Come on now.
Come on now. That's a fly.
It was fly jacket.
And we were the same size, so we were shit.
That's the only reason he was okay with it. He's like, you bought another jacket?
I'm like, let me see. Medium? Yeah, no, we good.
I told him, I said, okay, I know I shouldn't have bought anything, but we get to share it. So technically, it was like I spent 15 and 15 on us. Mm-hmm. Right?
And I'm like, so if I wear it at least 15 times, that's like $1.
There you go. But I mean, hey, if that Arctic
blast come through, man, I got to start wrapping these pipes and shit.
Can you go check my sister's too, please?
Ooh, okay. She got a brand new house, though. It should already be.
She said it was already done, so I just need you to go check to make sure. Isn't that cool? Brand new houses. They already did them for them. Mm. Lucky her. Too bad you got to go out there. Maybe next time we'll buy a brand new house.
Oh, and today, you'd have been proud of me today. I had to go pick up some shrapnel, you know what I'm saying? Like a piece of fence. Had to go get demo day. That's what we call it in the construction game, demo day. So I had to,
demolition day?
I had to like pick up the fence and, you know, it was like trash, heavy trash.
That's what we call it. Well, I had a sweep, and then I had to.
You know, my journeyman ain't show up, and these subcontractors.
I couldn't believe he was going to go do it. I said, what?
I said, lady, I was wearing my gloves already. I was like, lady.
Lady at my job. This is what's happening.
Get in the house.
I'm glad you did it.
Yeah. Now I got to fix
it. Listen.
Juan, you going to help me when it's time to go.
All right.
Fix the fence. Yeah.
Hold the end of the tape measure.
PJ, we're going to have to call PJ.
PJ, all three of y'all.
PJ's going to be doing all the work.
My brother-in-law got hurt. He like got a hernia or something. So.
Oh, no.
So I borrowed his truck and, you know, I feel like a man in a pickup truck.
Were you lifting correctly? Because the last thing we need is for you to have a hernia.
No, I'm good. I didn't step on no nail. That was probably like the biggest danger.
Oh my God, hernias are awful. I just had surgery for that.
Now that I think about it, I probably should have been a little bit more careful when it comes to how I was having to step on boards, knowing it was a bunch of like nails.
And were you wearing like your construction boots?
My good origin boots, you know what I'm saying? My Jocko Willink.
Oh, you would have been fine, I'm sure. Maybe.
I think it'd probably gone through and then tetanus shots.
I thought they were supposed to be like stainless steel. Or the boots from the Chaco guy.
Stainless steel.
I mean, what is that?
Steel toe boot.
Steel toe. There you go. Whatever.
They don't protect the bottom, though.
Yeah, but you step on a nail, that ain't got nothing to do with
Dear
the toe.
Dear Jocko, you did not make those correctly. Why and they were steel very toe? Expensive boots, and I had to pre-order it.
There's steel toe on the toe part. That's Mighty why
and I had
toe.
To pre-order it.
Mighty Soul's like, why didn't you steel sole?
Steel something. Still pimping.
Speaking of pimping.
Oh, yeah. Did we talk about Katt Williams yet?
No, we have not.
That's what the fireplace. Oh, you turned it off.
Yeah, it was hot. Oh, yeah. So Katt Williams broke the internet. Like,
no, all, destroyed.
Hey, listen. Like a billion. I saw this meme that said, demolished. Hey, it said the, you know, the files that came out. I don't want to say it in case
about the we island. Get.
Oh, yeah.
And then it said, and then it had a picture of
Chris Tucker.
Katt Williams, and then it said all the things just happened in 2024. Like it just like it's too many of them. It's only like 7 days in.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy.
There's a quote. It said, "Sometimes there's decades where weeks happen, and then there's weeks where decades happen."
Bro, there's too much happening in 1 week of, like, This is the first Sunday of the month.
The video is at 32 million already.
And he said, oh, no.
But that's only on one platform, right?
That's on YouTube. Yeah.
That's on his platform?
That's just the main video that came out, the full interview, the YouTube.
That's not even counting clips.
Yeah, that's not counting anything else. That's just 32 million just on that. So that was a 2-hour and 45-minute podcast. 32 million views.
I heard something.
And then all the retweets.
Well, yeah, I heard there was like 250 million on one of the videos or something, one platform or something crazy. Somebody tweeted it.
Okay, so, and then I saw, what's that one guy? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What is his
Club
name?
Club Shay Shay.
No, he's a comedian.
Ricky Smiley.
Mm-mm.
White guy?
No. I forget what his name is, but he said basically one thing people don't know is how generous Katt Williams is. And that whole thing he talked on the Shay Shay episode where he said, like, I heard you get women to go give money to comics. That guy confirmed it. And oh my God, why can't I remember
Boosie? Lil Boosie?
No, I'm going to tell you right now who he is. Hold on. Go ahead. Go ahead while I look this up because it's going to drive me bananas.
Okay, listen. I think he's very misunderstood. Mm-hmm. And it's funny how when people have such poignant things to say, they get labeled crazy or he's on drugs or something like that, right? And do y'all remember when he had that controversy where the narrative was Katt Williams goes on racist rant against a Mexican fan in the crowd? Do y'all remember that? Well, everybody bought that narrative, especially Mexicans, because sometimes Mexicans are very sensitive and they believe shit. So Mexicans were in an uproar. I had already met Katt Williams at this point, so I was like, bro, I wasn't in comedy yet, so I couldn't say, I didn't know, like, bro, it's a heckler, and he's roasting a heckler because he's disrupting the show. That's really what that's about. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know that. I was just like, man, he's not racist, bro. Like, he's just going off on this one dude.
Yeah.
But, of course, I caught some flack because, like, why are you defending that vato, homie? Da, 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 da.
Yeah. And the white comic, I said, was Gary Owens.
But what'd he do? What'd he say?
Oh, Gary Owen was just telling everybody because he was like, man, am I catching strays? Because he didn't know, because he had said
why he mentioned
why he hadn't like moved up in the business. And he's like, oh, and then he had to like think about it. He's like, I guess he is right. Because then he started thinking about all the auditions and stuff he went to and stuff and then things that they would tell him. He was like, man, you're kind of insinuating some stuff. But he's like, he would always turn him down. And then
finally, wait, he's saying that
he's confirming like what Katt Williams was saying about him.
But what did he say about? I thought he said that's why Gary's a white guy.
No, because he was saying Gary. That's why somebody like Gary, who's really good, but he's never crossed over, meaning like he's never sold his soul.
Okay,
basically. So that's what he was saying. But then Gary had to think about it. Like, what does he mean by that? And when he thought about it more, he's like, oh, that's what he means. But he like confirmed what he said. Look, everything Katt Williams said was 100%. I would say pretty much true. And then some of the other stuff, like the assumption parts, those are a little off. But I mean, you can't really, because to him, that's what it seems like. You know what I'm saying? Like with the whole Kevin Hart thing, that was kind of like, it could be a hit or miss, because he's like, I don't know how he got famous. Do you? Because yeah. he phrased it in a question. But everything else he said about Steve, about all these other people, everything he's saying, there's nothing wrong with it.
Did you see Ice Cube's reply?
Yeah, but that was, again, from a perspective that he didn't have. Like, he didn't know that, he probably didn't know that what's his name went up for like a casting thing early on.
Yeah.
Because he was never informed of it.
Yeah, that, yeah. So there.
You said that too. It was like perspectives also, mm-hmm. you know, so.
But I mean, everything he said, that's the crazy thing. He was keeping it 100. Like, the two major things I was like really blown away with was the P. Diddy thing. The P. Diddy thing, he's like the first one to ever say on TV or on anything that, yeah, dude, like, he does those parties and they're that freaky or whatever it is. Nobody's actually just confronted and said that out loud.
You know, maybe just on YouTube or like
behind the computer screen, for sure. Like, behind like keyboards and stuff, like, people will say it, but nobody's ever.
Or innuendo, like people in podcasts. Like, you saw that one clip when was it Desi Banks saying, like, well, now that I'm coming up in this game, like, what should I look out for? And I forget who it was. I was like, okay, let's see. Yeah, if Diddy. No, he said, if the take that guy invites you to a party, don't go.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah, see, it's stuff like that, but that, nobody's ever just said it. That's why it's crazy. That's why it's wild.
You got to tell him no.
Also, the party. also, though, I mean, I can't wait for these people to want to start speaking out on it.
They already did.
Everybody did, because they even got Bernie Mac's daughter to try to get like her take on it. Did you see that?
Mm-hmm. And she backed him up.
She just said, I never met him. You know, I'm assuming he's a cool dude. Like
everything that her dad has said about him has been good. And then the stuff that she said, I don't know Katt Williams. Like, I've never met him. Like, I was never met him personally. But like, when he actually said, gave my dad props, she's like, no, I actually believe him. Like, I've heard other people, like, the way she said that too, like, I wonder if she was talking about Steve, but like, I've had other people say it about my dad, and they're never genuine. Like, yeah. this actually seemed genuine. Like, she came out backing him up, you know what I mean?
One of my takeaways about this whole thing is basically Katt Williams being a purist and saying, like, I have standards. And I have, like, rules and boundaries. Like, I'm not going to do a row a certain way just because I'm thirsty. You know, and then you see the contrast with that that amount of integrity. You see the contrast. It's pointing out the contrast of how some other people, you're able to be like, okay, like, man, so, yeah, y'all way more thirsty here.
I think the pendulum's swinging back, where the pendulum used to be only these comics and you had to move up in a certain way and it'd be old school, right? And then the new pendulum going the other way is like more like Rogan and all the other guys of like, we bring each other up and everybody's happy. Everybody's friends. Mm-hmm. We can all get along. And then they do their dirt behind closed doors. As far as like, you know, if there's like there's like something going on with two people, they just won't talk about it on air. They'll insinuate, but they'll never say it. Katt was like, man, fuck all that. He just like, I'll air it all out because it's what it is. Yeah. It's all real. This is, they came on here. They said their little things.
So what did Steve Harvey say though?
He's probably the only one. Everybody else, Ludacris, everybody else. But I don't think Steve's made it.
Steve, I thought they said anything. He did.
Did he? I didn't see anything for him.
Supposedly I saw a video on Instagram. I mean, on YouTube, but I didn't click it because I was trying to do my little training.
They're tearing up Cedric the Entertainer. They're tearing him up.
What are they saying?
He responded real quick and was like, look, man, I don't know. That was like 30 years ago. I don't know what you're talking about. And he was like kind of saying.
Yeah, he
like,
stole a joke, right?
Yeah. And he was kind of saying whatever he was saying. And then towards the end, he's like, hey, man, but like, I mean, I've had people steal my joke too, as well. And then he's just like, that was the end of it. And everybody in the comments, as well? What the hell is that? You just contradicted yourself.
Man, I'm a big Cedric entertainer.
Oh, bro, they brought out the footage. They brought out the footage.
Like, splice.
They brought out the footage.
They did.
They brought out the old one of like Katt doing the whole mannerisms and everything.
The original.
And then you had Cedric do pretty much the same thing with music and the spaceship thing. It was off.
I can't find this guy's name, he kind of looks like D.L. Hughley, though.
Oh, here's another big thing. you know, because I am going on tour, right? Burbank, California, February 8th. Whole bunch of tickets and stuff all on the website, chingobling.com. Check for your city. We're coming everywhere. But I'm really inspired by, like, Katt's, like, and he could back up all that stuff he was saying, right? And he showed you how methodical he was about, like, no, I'm telling you why I know I'm funnier. Like, this is the metrics, you know? And this is the part. When he said, every time I go back to a city, they trust that I'm going to bring them some fresh stuff. You know what I mean? They're going to show up and I'm going to show up type of thing. And that is what just the product, you know, that raw, you know, that's like the goal. That's what you really want. And I must say that, like, I'm grateful for the new people that are discovering me, people that have been had my back, people that know me from different eras and chapters and years and things like that. So, and I just came back from Corpus Christi shooting some music video footage.
No, I'm sorry. It's D-Ray. Sorry.
D-Ray Davis. I didn't see his interview. I didn't see what
he said. He was performing. Some lady just came up to him. He thought it was some kind of groupie trying to give him his phone number. And he said he just kind of like didn't even look to see what was handed to him. And then he said he basically like later walked off and was like, where'd this lady go? It was $1,000 in his hand. And the girl said something about you talented or some shit like that. So he was thinking later on, he finds out it was Katt Williams because he had heard another comic saying, man, some girl just came up to me and handed me $1,000. And so that's how he put two and two together. And they said Katt Williams was in the audience.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. There was another comedian that came out and said that he actually left like a, it was something wrapped in something. I forgot what it was. It was wrapped in like a cloth or something, and he didn't know what it was. It was
and the then money. He was on Sherry on the Sherry show, mm-hmm. and she said, "What nobody knows is like how generous you are, like, and what you do for a lot of people. Like, he's like, you've given away houses, you've given away cars," and then she laughs and said, "But you ain't never given me nothing yet." You know what I'm saying? And so, but, you know, like, he does a lot. And that's pretty effing dope, man, that you can do that, that you can bless, like, another person like that.
I think he does it for people that he knows don't have shit. Like, that's the thing. Like, the other girl, she probably has stuff, you know what I mean? But, like, he probably knows guys that are, like, slumming it, you know what I mean, and barely making it in comedy, like D-Ray whenever he first started out and stuff, and then doing that for him.
Or any comic.
And he gave Boosie 15 racks when he was just got out of prison.
Because his story was, as a kid, I think that's a big thing, too, is him being homeless when he was a teenager and then figuring it all out and then knowing how easy he can get the money. So, like, it's not, money's not a factor for him, especially since he started homeless.
And I wonder I read between the lines, right? That's kind of, so I'm assuming his brothers went to CPS.
Well, he says he didn't know what happened. So he didn't want to say too much on that. Like, he,
I know. And that's kind of like, I wanted to know what happened with that. But it looks like CPS got involved where he was being abused, you know? And so then it was like, I don't know what happened to them. So I wonder if he like reconnected with them.
Hey, so
I do know that's why he's adopted 7 kids, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I know there's probably like guilt there, but you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think all them kids, like, he know it's like a relative or something, like somebody had problems. But so I hung out with him, right? I met him before, and maybe I'll tell y'all the story so I don't bore everybody, but I'll tell y'all the story, and then y'all could tell me if there's a way. Because look, in my notes. For this year, I'm not saying I'm gonna do all these, but se me vienen cosas where I'm like, man, oh, there's that one funny thing that Eddie Bravo, you know what I mean? That one time, and it's like, I'll just write down, you know, as they're calling your name, you know, whatever the tag is. Or it's like, and like right now, I just jotted down. I was like, man, the time I met Katt Williams, I just don't wanna do a series of jokes of like, oh, did I tell you P. Diddy tried to sign me? And then I go through that whole thing, and then it's...
Ew, imagine if you would have.
You got to hear this joke. You're going to have to wait for this tour. You know, because that sometimes would be one of my regrets at times. Like, what would have happened? But I think I dodged a bullet.
Well, at least, like he said, booty hole ain't been touched. So
came out the game of virgin. So I guess I'll tell y'all we're at the mark now, but I'll tell y'all later just to see as because I'm trying to formulate my set. And by the time I do Houston, February 23rd and 24th, like I want to really just because I got Burbank and then what's after Burbank? Another California. So I want to start like polishing.
Yeah.
I'm excited. Like,
and I thought it was pretty damn cool when they he said on the Sherry show, this was 2 months ago. Also, he has something happening in Vegas. The clip was 2 months ago, so I don't know how old. I don't know if somebody just decided to make, you know how you can just decide to make shorts.
Some shit.
Uh-huh. So it'll show when the, so I don't know how old that interview is, but it was when he had Mark Cooper. He did a whole thing for Vegas where he's having a show there. So anyway, I was like, oh, that's interesting. I wonder if it's still happening because that'd be dope to go watch, you know? But long story short, man, what were we talking about before? Damn, y'all.
Talking about how
it's been 2 years and I still have, feel like I have mom brain.
Basically, we're just saying like how I met him. I'm hitting the road. I'm trying to formulate these jokes. Is it going to be 2 minutes?
Oh, thank you. Yes.
I don't want to do too many
stories.
So
he doesn't, the reason he doesn't practice in clubs is so that nobody tries to steal his jokes. Obviously, it took him one time to learn his, like, to be like, I'm not letting this happen to me again.
Talking about Katt Williams?
Yeah, Katt Williams. So he practices in his home.
With
himself. I don't know who his audience is. I'm just saying, he doesn't go out to perform.
He probably just records it or whatever. But he probably knows where the punchlines are.
Yeah, I think at his level, bro, you know if it's going to work or not. You know if it's funny or not.
But like, his brain works interesting. Like, I was, while the interview was happening, I was just, like, amazed at how his brain was working. Like, how it was just, he was saying things without saying things. You see what I'm saying? And it was like, oh.
Oh, in the interview?
Yeah,
there was a lot of that.
There was a lot of that.
You have an uncanny allegiance to losers, and it's not some crazy ass shit like that. What did he just tell them?
You have an uncanny allegiance to losers, and it's very unlike you because he's like, you're a winner.
Yeah.
Like, and you're with these losers.
Yeah.
That's basically what
it is. Come on, okay. Hey, my sister was telling me that we should splice in Theo Hoover. Like asking the questions, like, hey, wait, ¿qué pasa con el P. Diddy way? You know what I mean? Yeah. And like, let it cut and just be a short.
Oh, that'd be good.
He was like, oh, Kat. When he was like, we no longer have Friday Chris Tucker. We have Epstein Island Chris Tucker.
Come on, Kat.
He was like,
there was a few of those. There was that.
He was like,
what was the other one? There was the other one about Kanye and then Kim.
Because he married a whore.
He was like, cool. He was like, okay, that's not what I meant. I didn't mean it like that. Okay, this is what I mean. He knew she was like a whore.
And I was like,
what I mean is he didn't do that without knowing she was a, you know?
Like, he approved
he
it.
He knew.
He approved it. That's the reason he got with her.
We might go too deep on this, but maybe on the next episode. The conspiracy theory that Pete Davidson and can we say her name? I don't want to be on no list. Her husband was on the flight log, and she ran for president.
Hillary?
Yeah,
I think it's Hillary.
Okay, you said it.
Bill,
you're gonna be like, man, what happened to our channel?
What about
Pete Davidson and Hillary sitting in the tree?
Oh, see, like. Right now,
like that's like no. We're like just throughout, like you know, they booed up. That's why he got her tatted on him.
Remember when Kanye was
like, I didn't know how close Kim was to them people, and it's you know how people look at like the Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift.
I just can't take anymore. I can't take anymore. Like I'm tired of like these damn bombs dropping all the time. It's like what
you like, didn't everything's know. Everything's
a lie. Even like. On the Roseanne Barr podcast, it's like she drops stuff all the time, and I'm just like Roseanne, hold on a second. First of all, I'm usually driving either A, like to the gym, or I'm driving to the store, or you know, it's like early, and so this is what I listen to on my way. And I'm like, I'm sitting there, I'm like, I just prayed, I just listened to my gospel music that I do, like my little ritual that I do every morning, and then it's like. Bam, it's like you hear some news and you're like, just like, Yeah, I wasn't ready for this.
Like this morning, well, we're filming this on a Sunday. This morning, watching church, and I'm like, okay, we got this sermon about to come on. Next thing you know, Officer Tatum comes out. I was like, okay, I guess so. she chose violence.
Oh, because church was still. It is
January 7th.
Hey, listen, no, because church, it was still showing that it was a few minutes before they went live.
Oh, she's like, so we got
we got a couple minutes. Let me see what he's talking about.
Let me indulge.
You know, so I hit.
She's like, in some politics.
Did y'all see that stupid, what is it, Fox News anchor, like, crying over the...
That's what a network had somebody crying.
I think it was Fox. I'm pretty sure it was Fox, where he was just like...
Tell us. I feel like I would have known if it was...
I got to look it up again, but yeah. I'm telling...
I'm sure it is.
It's one of those networks where he's like, he has this guy...
crying because he was scared and because he thought...
Wrote a book. This guy, he had this guy on that wrote a book about the incident in January from 2 years ago, or 3 years ago, whatever. And he was just like... tell us about how brave you are, and I just want to thank you for your service. And I was like, wow.
Yeah, it was probably MSNBC, bro. Come on. If you're going to be interviewing
that might be the dude
that's basically lying up there lying. Yeah,
that just seems stupid. Like,
that dude.
That's what I'm saying. I can't take anymore.
And that officer, he's running for Congress now, and he said they called him all kind of words and stuff. And there's like.
This is what I can't do anymore. It's like. If you're still living under a rock and you don't think any, like, you're really not paying attention, you're about to be in big trouble for 2024. Because, you know, I try my hardest to avoid politics, because when you consume too much of it, I don't know about, well, I do know about you, but I don't know about you, Juan. Like, your brain just goes, and then it's going, and then you're just like, oh, okay, I'm just going to be honest with y'all. The other day, I was like, okay, they say something's going to happen this year. So I'm looking at my food supply, right? And I'm just supply like, chain. I was like, oh my God. I was like, okay, cool. I know in the meat department, we're straight. But what about the other stuff? Like,
as long as we don't lose power.
I'm just like, as long as the grid holds up, exactly.
That's the problem.
Yes. I don't know what
generators.
Generator only works for a week.
After a while.
And I have to start cooking everything and I can't even freeze it. You see what I'm saying? So like my brain is like going like, okay, what? Okay, we got some buckets, but those buckets are not enough. Okay, we got to have like how many? I like start doing math. Like, okay.
She's like 2,000 calories a day times.
Yeah. And my husband, y'all.
What I do now?
He's going to snack and eat up all the food before we can even, like...
You don't want me on your team.
You do not.
On that note, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Cafecito Time Coffee is available. And it's
cinnamon. I like that flavor.
It's cinnamon pecan. So
it's really
shout
good.
Shout out to Grind Ops Coffee Co. That's a super cool collab. I'm very proud of our coffees.
Wait, shipping real quick. Out. ChingoTheMerch.com. Can I just say something real quick?
What's up? Are you proud of me?
I'm very proud of you. But one other thing. Like, and I'm not just saying this because it's our coffee, but the Keurig was on sale.
The Keurig.
And so, how do you say it?
No, I know.
Okay.
Keurig.
Okay.
But I'm trying to make it sound cool. Keurig.
Okay, so it was on sale. I decided to purchase it.
It's on Instagram.
So we tried. Everybody keeps saying, "Oh, why do you brew coffee?" Right? Because I make coffee from scratch in my Bialetti. Bialetti should really sponsor me, because if they knew how many of their gadgets I owned, Bialetti, if you was watching,
if you knew my wife was a collector
of Bialettis, I really want my big Bialetti back. If you want to buy me anything, I'd love to have my big Bialetti back. Just saying.
Where is it?
Remember, it stopped working, like the filter.
Uh-huh.
So anyway, back to the coffee real quick. But if you don't know what Bialetti is, go look up a Bialetti coffee maker. You'll never want coffee and anything else again. And this is the perfect coffee to go with your Bialetti. But I tried the Keurig coffee. It's great for on the go. Like, we got to go make it real fast.
It's great for dentist offices.
It's definitely not my choice of coffee. I bought Bustelo because that's the coffee I feel is closest to our coffee, I guess, if I wanted to compare, right?
Because the other one, Red Pill Blend, maybe.
So I'm not digging it.
She's not sold on
I'm not sold cured. On the machine. That's got to be for, that's something that I would just like use if I have a guest. Like if I have somebody who does, if you're not a coffee drinker, that's for you.
She's like, that's what I'm going to give you.
That's what you're going to have. Because I would not give you some of my good stash. This is like the good drugs. That's like the
Snickle Fritz.
Just saying. On that note, peace out. Buy the coffee.
On that note, stop drinking Snickle Fritz, shakes, coffee. And get you some of that Dro. It's that loud coffee. All right, y'all. It's so good. Oh, wow. Cafecito time. All right. Peace.
Bye.